we're live again. This Sunday and next Sunday, gonna be the next Sunday, the last one of the year, Sunset Sunday. We're here again with business partner Kent. What's going on, man?
Brother Smith, nothing much. What's going on with you, sir? I'm just looking forward to, for those of us who are still, you know, on the clock, so to speak, looking forward to that short work week. And even though I won't be spending time with my family, I'm still going to enjoy the Thanksgiving holiday. Make the best of it.
Hey, a lot of people are in that boat, man. With this pandemic and with all this stuff that's going on, with the people being, you know, talking about being shut down for stuff. Things are just different this year. They're trying to help people so you have time for Christmas or in next year. Because this ain't no joke. You know, this whole thing ain't no joke.
Not at all.
And they need to, people need to really understand. I had this friend of mine who was trying to go to Atlanta. I said, you need to stay your butt at home. She wanted me to take care of her. She has the brother of the cat that I got, of sneakers. But then I thought about it. I said, you know what? I ain't trying to do that. I ain't trying to have everybody, you know, too many people around here either. So I don't know what she did as far as, you know, I think she stayed home, but she, you know, she got a dog and a cat, but you know, but it is what it is. But like I said, today we're going to talk about, you know, there's been a lot in the last few months. You've been seeing, you know, because of the economy, because of this pandemic, because of all our stuff. I've been seeing, especially posted online, a lot of different companies are shutting down. Or actually, let me rephrase it. They're shutting down their brick and mortar and they're going strictly to online.
Right.
We're a week out of, almost a week out of Cyber Monday, Black Friday, because the holidays are coming up, Thanksgiving's next week. You know, we could probably see an uptick even more so of online shopping, Black Friday specials online, Cyber Monday. Shoot, you're probably going to have cyber weeks now during November.
No doubt.
People are not shopping like that anymore. I don't know if you've seen any of that kind of stuff online. You know, I know we talked about this before. And people got to realize this is where we're at. In the climate of 2020, going into 2021, and it's going to be even more so with that type of environment. What are your thoughts about that, Kent?
Well, and for the businesses that we just alluded to, some of them were having some issues even pre-COVID. And they're just, I mean, it just makes business sense to centralize your operations, cut down on your costs so you can keep your revenue if not increase it from a business standpoint. That just makes sense.
Yeah. If you're already having problems with brick and mortar, you know, brick and mortar, you got to pay that. Get those utilities to pay, you get the rent, wherever it is you got to pay. And a lot of times in these malls are expensive. And if they're not bringing in the revenue to make sense of having a brick and mortar, you know, a lot of times when you look at brick and mortar and when you got an online presence, you kind of fighting against your own self. Mm-hmm. And then you got to decide, okay, where's most of my revenue coming in? Is it coming in online or is it coming in foothold brick and mortar? And you know, you get this argument from people say, well, I don't like shopping online for certain things because I gotta feel and touch things. Well, that's fine. But at the end of the day, it's gonna be up to the business owner of the store, and they're gonna have to make a decision whether their brick and mortar presence is it worth it because if they're not getting foot traffic and if they're getting more traffic online, it makes more sense from a business standpoint. They can't worry about what you like. Okay. More and more people every year for the last 10, 15 years during the holidays, online shopping has been outdoing brick and mortar. Okay. The stats have been coming out. The stats come out this year. It's going to be even triple the thing because of the pandemic and because of the shutdown and all that kind of stuff. So it's just going to make more sense that people are going to shop. You know, them days of going after Thanksgiving to the store, waiting in line, Best Buy and all that shit, that made no sense in the first place. Them days is really over.
Right.
Stay home and enjoy your family or join the people that are in your household. Why y'all need to go in there and be, you're going to get deals anyway. In fact, you probably get better deals online than you would sitting in out at 4 o'clock in the morning trying to get some better deal on some stuff. And that never made no sense to me. I guess it's just some people made it a tradition.
Like a ritual, yeah.
An event or, you know, stuff like that. I just never was into that kind of stuff. I got a friend, Tanya, used to do that stuff. She said she used to do that when, especially when her child was younger. They used to go and stand in line like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't want nothing that dang gone bad. I'm gonna stand in line at 4 o'clock in the morning or 6 o'clock in the morning.
I like it earlier
and earlier.
Yeah, I like my sleep too much to be doing all that. You know?
Yeah, that thing got earlier and earlier. It started being 6 o'clock in the evening. And it was still on Thanksgiving. People were getting in line, lining up. I said, come on, people. At least have a time with family and time. You know, it got to a point, Thanksgiving was like eat and run.
Yeah.
Like you go to family places and these teenagers and some 20, they act like you were the damn Smiths or somebody delicatessen. They eat and run and they gone. No, we ain't having that shit. Nah, this time. This year, that stuff, hey, it's just me and my mother.
Yeah.
I'm not dealing with all that mess. Mm-hmm. You know, that's a lot of work to be cooking for somebody to come over and eat it up and run. Now, when you were and me, when we was growing up, with Thanksgiving, aunts and grandmothers, it was a family thing.
Right. Oh, yeah, man. I can remember growing up in the bean, for those who don't know what the bean is. The bean is just Lima, Ohio, we just call it the bean because of Lima bean. But growing up in the bean, it'd be at least 20 people in our house Thanksgiving.
Right.
Thanksgiving.
My grandmother's house in New Jersey and stuff, there'd be a lot of people coming in and out there. I remember that was Christmas time, I think. The last Christmas my grandfather was alive, me and my dad went to Jersey or something. Man, it was Thanksgiving. I don't know. We had to go back to the store 3 times to get a turkey.
Yeah.
Because he said it wasn't big enough. Okay. Damn. You know? So that's why we probably, both of us grew up with that kind of stuff because that's what I was a family time and stuff like that. And a lot of people nowadays, they take it for granted that, you know, somebody going to be there to cook. And if you ain't learning how to cook, you're going to be ass out. You better learn how to cook. I'm cooking a turkey this year. This is going to be the second time.
And
my wife's doing it.
And Thanksgiving Day is really not the best time to learn to cook.
No, but you know what? You know what? There's too many things out there now. The Cooking Channel.
Yes.
Food Network to learn this kind of stuff. That's what I learned how to do the brining stuff from somebody. One of them, either buy or I don't know, it's one of them guys or gals on there. And I did a turkey. When did I do a turkey? 2018? One of them times. It turned out, people asked me, well, how come the white meat is so moist? Because, you know, a lot of people, when they tell you to do a turkey, they say the white meat is dry. I say, I brine it. It's just another form of marinating. That's all. And I'm like, you know.
Oh, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, I picked up another basting technique. I was just flipping through channels on through one of the cooking shows earlier today. He said, "I never thought about that, but it was another basting technique that, I mean, I'm like, wow, okay, how come I didn't pick up on this earlier? So yeah. I might try that with this turkey."
Well, yeah, you learn a lot. Hey, if you single, male, don't be depending on a damn female.
I'd be a lot thinner. I'd be a lot thinner if I didn't know how to cook.
You know, because if you don't, you won't have nothing to eat depending on somebody else to do that mess.
Exactly.
And it's just, those are the type of things, you know, that's the great thing that we got now with social media and internet, is because there's so many things you can learn, self-taught, learning different things. I learned something this week about, you know, everybody's so little bit leery on why, you know, they're talking about if they would take the, you know, they're talking about this COVID vaccine maybe coming out. I just heard like the 13th of this month. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you've seen this. There was a show that comes on MSNBC with Richard Engel called On Assignment. He's always somewhere in the world. Well, this was something that it wasn't even brought out to the public until now. I bet some people don't even know if they didn't watch the show. When they discovered about the COVID virus, and, you know, at first they were showing that China, you know, they were trying to squash it down because they noticed it happened last year in December. Right around New Year's, our time, you know? But when they kind of got a hold of them and knew what was going on, in January, they actually got the genetic code of the virus and put it on the internet to all the scientists, pharmaceutical, whatever places, to get the genetic code. This is why they've been able to come up. They've been working about a year on this vaccine, because they got the genetic structure of this virus to find out what its weaknesses are, what they could do, and all that other stuff. And see, people, you know, because at one time they were talking about, well, you know, all these viruses don't usually get a vaccine for a couple of years, and I don't know if I'm gonna trust it, but I said they must have been doing something to been able to really get this stuff, because they were talking about it even last January and February. They said they've been saying 12 to 18 months, but they never, nobody ever, not even Dr. Fauci,
right,
said anything about that China had put online for these people who developed these vaccines of the genetic code of this virus. And once you got that structure and understand how this thing moves, works, and, you know, they always talk about the spike proteins of this thing I've been hearing. So that's why this thing is coming out. So that kind of makes a lot of sense why they've been able to do this, because they've been working around the clock with this thing all over the world.
Right.
You know. So with that being said, this goes back to what I've been saying and what we've been saying about technology, social media, and everything that's going on. That's another proof or solidifies what we've been talking about. And I just talked about, you know, putting that on the internet for these scientists to work on a vaccine, how important the internet has been in our lives. Because without that, they wouldn't have been at, we've been fucked. Really, because if they didn't have that those technologies to do that kind of stuff, we've been in a pandemic straight two to 3 years probably. You know, in 1918, that thing didn't end for 2.5 years because they didn't have this technology.
Right.
You know, it took that long time for them to develop a vaccine, because they didn't have the technology to know the genetic code of what was there, you know, to deal with. And it's just like now, like I said, you know, all these stores that are closing, GNC, Macy, Nationwide, shut down all their stuff and go on virtual, is because of the foundational platforms of social, the internet and social media. It's been a saving grace. I mean, if you want to look at it from that standpoint, that's been, I think that's what really, and you can't argue the fact that's what's really saved the economy. If it wasn't for that, the economy would have went into a depression, a hyper recession into a real depression.
No doubt.
It's just a thing that we got to really look at and take advantage of, because we're not going back. I cannot see us going back to pre-COVID. What are your thoughts on that?
I know the word new normal has been tossed around, but yeah, we are definitely in the new normal. Even, and let's just say for the sake of argument, even if, let's say, 6 months from now, 6 months or 7 months from now, for whatever reason, the pandemic is lit, people are not going to, I can only speak for me, but people are not going to want to go back into an office setting, especially if there's going to be, because before the office that I work for, it's about 500 people work there. People are not going to want to, at least in my mind, are not going to want to go back to that setting, especially even with any restrictions, because you know you're still going to have to be at least six feet apart.
Yeah.
Folks are going to have to wear masks when they go in, and they're going to have to keep that mask on. Probably not while obviously you're eating or drinking, but for the most part, you're going to have to wear a mask.
And nobody want to sit there with a mask on all day for 8 hours. Right. I wouldn't. Right. And another thing I think is going to affect a lot of things is going to be the college structure. Mm-hmm. Now, I did my college online 10, 15 years ago before this pandemic, all that stuff. And, you know, companies were looking at me. You went to school online. You didn't do the da-da. Well, okay, get the same information. It doesn't matter how you get it. You know, that's been the discussion with a lot of people, even in the profession of network marketing. They got this turned up nose thing about, well, you cannot build, it's not duplicatable. Duplicatable is not duplicatable. Okay, that you cannot build a network marketing company online. It's all about building a network. That's why I call it network marketing. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's not called prospect marketing. And like I said, there's a difference between prospecting and marketing, and there's a difference between prospecting and a prospect. Okay, we got to get all those type of things clear. Words matter, and in the context of how you use them, especially when you're out and when you're doing things with new people coming into this arena every day, they're going to need to know that. They're going to need to know a defined difference on what you're talking about. There's too many things today in this business that are used interchangeably, and they're not correct, okay? It's just like today we were talking about, they've been talking about how they were blaming Congress for not doing their part with the bill, you know, the relief bill. I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
It's not Congress is the problem. Mm-hmm. It's the Senate. They're talking about the Congress, everybody went home. No. The House Congress has been there working, a lot of them. Mitch McConnell's the one that sent a lot of people from the Senate home. There is a difference. They're all part of that business structure, but there is a defined difference between the Senate in the House. And there's too many people don't make that distinction, even on these journalists online, these shows. Yesterday on MSNBC, they didn't do it. They interchange so much things today. That's why you get all this confusion misinformation about certain things, but a lot of people didn't take civics either.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, exactly. They took out a lot of courses in school after me and you probably had graduated, and then they dumbed down the curriculum. And that's why you got some of these people who went to school really don't know shit. You know, they really don't. They spout off something where somebody else tells them on a prompter, and they don't critically think about what they're saying. Yesterday, one of the guys on there had mentioned that, Bob Dylan had died last year? And no, he didn't. And they had to come back and recant that. Come on, folks. You know what? You're giving, and I always say, you're giving ammo to 45 when he's saying fake news.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
You're giving that ammo. Get your shit together. Quit. Get that mess together about what's real and what's not, and quit spouting off misinformation. You know, I don't know where they got that from.
Yeah, I would have. Where did they get that from?
Well, you see it all the time. It's like you see people sharing stuff about folks who was supposedly had just died and they've been dead for 2 or 3 years. I'm like, people, this guy's been dead.
Right.
2016 or whatever. I'm like, people, stop. And it is a problem. It is a problem. And then we feed into that problem and then get mad when as they say, the right makes the statements about fake news and misinformation. Well, there's a lot of people on here help perpetuate their problem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like I said, the internet, social media is great, but it's not that vehicle's the problem. It's people and how they use it. It's just like anything else. Cars don't kill people. Drunk people behind them kill people. Guns is not the problem. It's the mentally ill person that's using it as killing people. It's like any inanimate object has no bearing on anything. It's the food that's supposed to be a higher level of species is the problem in anything. You know, just like we talked about, you know, what you post online, the information you post online is based off of what you bring to the table, not the internet, not the devices, not the camera, the mics, is you. Gotta be the responsible one. You know, it's just people want to make the money. They don't want to do the work. It's work.
Mm-hmm.
It's work all the way around this thing. Okay. And then now you gotta understand, you gotta be aware as an entrepreneur. You gotta be aware of what's going on in the world, not just because from a business standpoint, but because of all this stuff is interconnected. And you gotta understand what's happening and how it works and why people do what they're doing. That's why so much, you need to be a little bit educated about some certain things, but you know,
it gives
so many people so much freedom. You know, that's another thing. Hear people talking about their freedoms. It's bad to say, but I hear a lot, and I hear this mostly coming from Caucasian folks. They're always talking about their freedom, see, because they're witnessing the stuff we always had to witness.
Right, right.
You know, things that are maybe being taken away, and that's why they help. Oh, my freedom! And I was like, look, none of us want any of all this stuff, but we've always had to deal with certain aspects of this world because of the shame, you know. So, you know, y'all just are getting to know our world, you know. So it's crazy how people, when you start walking into other person's shoes, and they like realize, oh, yeah, there is no post prejudice because we had a black man in the White House. That didn't change anything. In fact, it probably made things worse. It did. Because that's why we're where we are today, because of that. that incident, that situation. Mm-hmm. Hey, unapologetic about it. That's your problem because y'all got a problem.
Right.
And so and you know, and we're at a time now that people are gonna have to be cognitive of what's changing in the world. We're at a time period where things are moving. It's moving faster than 6 months now. Things are changing month to month. We're moving at a rapid pace where technology, how we do things are running from a month to month aspect. And those who do not learn to keep up with that, they're gonna get left behind. Ain't nobody trying to go, nobody's going back to that way. If they do go back, it's gonna be such on a small level that it's not gonna even matter, okay? I mean, it could be a good thing because that way, you know, when we first started all this stuff, they started showing the planet, the atmosphere of the planet was clearing out.
Yeah.
All these places that had all this smog was clearing out. It was like the earth was healing itself.
Mm-hmm.
It was trying to tell y'all to slow the fuck down. Tranquilo. You know, and it was clearing out stuff. So, you know. Now, with that being said, I just don't see the necessity in going back to what we did in 2019 and before then. Why? Doing business like we're doing now, you could connect with somebody 5,000 miles across the water from your own home. Why? You know? If you're going to take a trip, you take a trip because you're doing it for pleasure, not because you got to do business. I mean, you can do business if you choose to. It's about having choice to do things. Right now, we're making this transition into a lot of different avenues of business, entertainment. Look what's going on now. We got a lot of movies being released straight to streaming. Remember when we talked about that in the beginning?
Yeah.
March with me, you, and Drew?
Right.
That they need to go straight to, if they want to keep their revenue going, they need to make a deal with Netflix, or Prime, Amazon, and that's what the hell they started doing.
Exactly. Coming to America, they're going right to Amazon next year.
Yeah. And those type of things, are just there's a very limited portion of movie theaters that are going to be opening up, and then with this resurgence with stuff, they're really not going to be able to do that.
No,
because people just not going to take the chance. They don't need to. Mm-hmm. And when you got video streaming, that's why everything is going to. You know, I meant to tell you, over on Nelson Road from here, they're opening up an Amazon fulfillment center.
Get out of here.
Yeah, if you go down Nelson Road towards, going north on Nelson Road towards 670 on the left-hand side, they tore down that big
where Sutherland's used to be.
Well, Sutherland things are still there, but the trucking company that was there.
Okay.
Remember that trucking company? That's gone. Yeah. That's gone.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and then across the street, they're building some kind of apartment thing. So this is just telling me what I've been saying. We probably, with that Amazon being built, a lot of internet structural fiber optics are going to have to be put in here because you're going to have that there. So why, you might as well run it, because if you're going to have fulfillment type centers and stuff, people gonna be shopping online, and bam, they gonna want their stuff.
Exactly.
And they can't have no flimsy ass internet connection. And AT&T need to get their shit together. All of them really need to get their shit together.
Well, yeah.
And quit playing this game, because these companies are opening up and they're doing, you know, we don't know. Well, we know it's changing. That's all I can say. Things are moving.
Mm-hmm.
Month to month, sometimes from week to week. And we just, you know, we got to be aware, and that's going to be our job as markets, especially going into 2021. We're going to have a lot of different things that are going to be coming up in the next few weeks, especially with this vaccine, how people, whether people are going to be going back to college physically, or is it going to be all virtual, we're going into spring and summer, because that makes no sense. I think Ohio State's out, aren't they? They're not coming back till January, which makes no sense. It makes no sense. Why go back to school after Thanksgiving? That don't make any sense.
I believe you're right. Well, yeah, because if I'm right, I think Thanksgiving break. Well, obviously Thanksgiving break either started. If it hadn't started this past week, it's starting this week.
I remember in the day Ohio University was out after Thanksgiving, and they didn't come back till the first of the year, which right. made a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. Why have kids go back to school, go out for that one damn day, that weekend, and come back for a few more weeks? That made no damn sense, didn't it? Get rid of it, go home for the rest of the year. And right now, with all this stuff that's going on, they need to do that. Ain't no sense in having them kids come back, and then you don't know if they're bringing shit back from their home to the campus or vice versa. They need to stay their ass home. Ain't no damn school, no education, no nothing is worth all that craziness, especially with this pandemic going around. And right. And these fools are still thinking this thing's a hoax. With a quarter of a million people dead, that's not no hoax. You know, it's not a hoax. And, you know, the business world is changing. I don't see the use in all those physical events that we were going to, and network marketing in that standpoint, they're going to have to adapt to a new environment.
Exactly.
It's all about information, people. It doesn't matter how you get information. It really doesn't matter how you network. Mm-hmm. True networking is going to have to be done, because the chasing people online is no different than you guys physically chasing people in the mall. Or that prospecting online, running around talking to people, trying to convince somebody to be in your business. That's bullshit. Market, folks. That's what this game is, network marketing. Networking and marketing. Ain't prospect marketing. Ain't prospect networking. It's network marketing. Right. Like I said, I wrote a book on that. I just got another sale on my book a couple of days ago. So, you know, it's just what it is. People got to understand what we truly, the environment we're living in. What is that? Coronavirus in Ohio Sunday update. I'm getting all these updates on what's going on in Ohio. And Franklin County's leading.
Yeah.
With the cases.
We're purple. Oh, my God.
Yeah. Hold on for a minute. Hold on. Mm-hmm. You take that out? Just make sure my mom took out that salmon. I made some salmon with some miso sauce. So.
All right, Master Chef.
Huh?
I said, all right, Master Chef.
No, I ain't no Master Chef. I just, that guy said. I was trying to replicate the miso sauce that miso salmon that I've gotten at Cheesecake Factory. They sell it. Hey.
Okay.
Okay. So that's what I was trying to do. Nice. Who knows? But yeah, man, it's just what it is, folks. It's this, we're in a situation that's changing, that's growing. It's a good thing. I know a lot of people, I know change is hard for a lot of people.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
I remember when the internet came about, there were network marketers. Especially in the business, the organization we were in, they're talking about, well, that's not true. Way you build a network marketing company without being face to face.
Yeah, I remember.
Get the hell out of here with that.
I remember.
What difference do it make how you do it?
Exactly. Holding on to
ideologies, because. Yeah, exactly. Because they were benefiting from it, and it was cutting into their revenue. That's what it was. And don't realize they can even make more money even faster by leveraging the internet and social media the way they were doing, instead of physically always having to do things, depend on people. And like, we got this guy doing our backyard. He tore down a lot of shrubbery branches and shit.
Okay.
He was talking about some friend and he was in landscaping, and he has an app that he does. He's making like $35,000. He said this guy was making $35,000 a month because of his app and doing stuff. I said, but you still, that's fine. But word of mouth is unreliable because it's based off of people. Yeah. Now the app is the one that's doing that's getting his message out and the marketing from that standpoint. If you're sitting there depending on people telling other people about your business, they can want to benefit from it.
Sure.
For some way, it's like this how, affiliate marketing is about.
Mm-hmm.
The whole purpose of affiliate marketing is marketing other people's products and services, and they pay you a commission based off the revenue or the volume that's running that month or whatever. That's what all that is. It's fine, but when it's always predicated or dependent on a person, that's where the tricky stuff gets to be in. That's where the beauty of leveraging social media and the internet is, because you can use apps, you can use software that don't get tired, that don't get an attitude. It may get glitchy or stuff, you know?
Yeah.
All those type of things. And you can sit back, like I said, I'm sitting there in the family room the other day, and I get this thing on my phone, royalty commission from your Amazon book thing. That's how you want to live. That's how most of your multimillionaires do.
Yeah, and you've written that, and you wrote that book 2 years ago, right?
I wrote it 3 years ago. It in 2016, and I published it in 2017.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm still getting stuff. I'll get getting paid for it.
Right, right.
So like,
even though I'm not a rapping fan of his, you want to be like Jay-Z. You want to get paid for stuff that you did in 1996, get that residual income, which is you still getting paid for things you did in 1996 or whatever year, you got a strong and profitable business.
It's just like some of them people that were on the Cosby Show, A Different World, were still getting paid because they were the show syndicated.
Exactly.
If the show gets syndicated out, they get paid for every time it's shown. Some people right now are getting paid for stuff in movies that they did 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Or series and stuff. That's why you got some of these people like that do like 4 or 5 series, and they all get syndicated, and they're getting paid from each of those series. That's a lot of cheddar coming in. Yeah, you ain't got to work for nobody.
Right.
And you wonder why they don't have to work or pick and choose a movie they want to do, because they're still getting paid for stuff that they did previously.
Exactly.
Okay. Exactly. Once you got that kind of, with shows that are running like that, just think in the days of I Love Lucy.
Mm-hmm.
I remember I Love Lucy used to show 5 or 6 times a day in New York.
Oh my God. Yeah.
So you can imagine every time that show was on, that show, them cats was like, ching-ching, ching-ching. Mm-hmm. It was ringing like a cash register for them.
That show used to play, there wasn't a day that show didn't air on TV.
And it's probably still running somewhere. Their descendants are probably making some, I don't know if that's transferable or not, but,
Right.
But that's how this residual passive income, you know, I got in a conversation with somebody about passive income, and they wanted to say to me, well, how do you make passive income? What's truly passive income? Is this such thing really truly passive income? I said, yeah. I gave them that example of people in a different world making money 10, 15 years after the show has been off because mm-hmm. it got syndicated. Okay? It's people who do investments. If you bought Apple stock, enough of it, you are still getting paid for that. You have to put the work in, create the asset to get paid from it. It ain't just that you just, oh, I want to make a residual income, you just do it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where people's minds are at when it comes to business. It's the mindset that a lot of people are still used to working 9 to 5.
Exactly. Right? That's what it is. You know.
And there's nothing wrong with it, but there has to be the biggest problem people have to understand when you're doing being an entrepreneur and being a self-employed person, as we show in the cash flow quadrant thing, there is a difference. Okay? There's a difference in that. And I've shown this many times on how people and the mindset of people and how they get paid. If you stay on the left side of the quadrant, those people, the employee and the self-employed pay the highest in taxes. This is like now. People are bitching about because Biden's in that he's gonna raise taxes on them. Okay. You know, if you're not making 400, if you're making less than 400 grand a year, you're not gonna get the tax hike on you. If you're making 400 grand on up, yeah, you're gonna get a tax hike. But people fail to understand those people that are making like that, and depending on how, like I said, depending on how you make that money.
Right.
Depending on how you make that 400 grand, it's going to depend on how you get taxed. Because they're not changing any loopholes.
No.
They're just taxing people based off of their income more. So if you're making your 400,000 based off of business, real estate, some kind of investments, you're still in a different bracket than the person who's just making that from working for somebody or self-employed. They're going to get taxed the highest. That's what people got to understand. That's where everybody get all angry and upset. There's a difference because them loopholes ain't changed. They're still there. And even those people who are millionaires or billionaires and stuff, you know, whatever they get taxed, they got to make more on that. You know, I used to hear Don Stone talk about that. He had to pay $2 or $3 million in taxes one time. He said, but you know you gotta make more than $2 or $3 million to pay $2 or $3 million in taxes. Okay?
Yeah.
He said, get that understanding. It's like I think maybe it was $1 million or something like that. He said, you gotta make more than $1 million to pay $1 million in taxes.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people don't get that either. Not so much. You know, it's what you make and how much you can keep is why the loopholes were developed for those people to take advantage of.
Mm-hmm.
He's not changing anything but taxing people based off of how they make money. And the way people make money is going to determine how much they get taxed on. That's still the basis because you know Biden's a millionaire, so he get royalty checks.
Okay.
So you think he's gonna fuck himself on the tax thing and not have some advantage of it? It's gonna be because now he's gonna get taxed. I don't know how he's getting taxed on, you know, being paid as being the president. They only make 400 some thousand a year. He's right there in that high tax thing. Okay. Mm-hmm. But the offset that he's gonna have is from books and other stuff that he's written. That's the thing they don't tell folks. On the Democrat or the Republican side, everybody fighting about what both are doing, but they don't look at, okay, this is what both of them are doing, mm-hmm. and they both are taking advantage of it. As business people, as worker bees, you can take advantage of it. It's just education, folks. It's getting the right education from the right people, from the right books, from the right things to understand how you too can take advantage. You're not gonna tell, it's like, this one thing I had about Elizabeth Warren, and everybody's talking about, well, we're gonna make the rich pay their fair share. No, the fuck you're not. You're gonna make the rich pay what they legally have to pay based mm-hmm. off the tax law. You ain't gonna make them pay no more than they have to. Okay, that's why, this is why Biden said, people making 400 grand and up are gonna get tax moves. He didn't get into the details of that, but that's up to right. you to educate yourself about.
Right.
And most people don't do that. They just get upset, get reactionary, get a, he don't care, man. The game is still gonna be the game. Mm-hmm. You know, so, you know, it's just one of those things, that people don't get, and like what's going on now, even those people that are going strictly online, yeah, it's a different ball game. Well, you know, it's going to help them economically because they don't have to pay for office space. They have to pay for warehousing, but that's cheap compared to having to pay for all these other employees and the employees that they may pay. They can have them working from home, customer service people, take orders, all right? Just like what Nationwide has done in all these other places. So we're in a new era, folks. We're in a new decade starting in a little more than 30 days. I don't see it going anywhere but where it's going. Now, where it's going, I couldn't tell you. It's going to go forward. It's going to go forward, way forward. What are your thoughts on that, man? I won't do all the talking.
Well, hey, you hit the nail right on the head. We're not going to see. I think the day, if the day is not already here, about major brick and mortar stores having a toehold, you know, as far as retail America goes, they're gonna have to shift their focus, and most already have, onto leveraging their business online.
Yeah,
we're not gonna see these. Big box stores like we're used to seeing. It's just not right now.
Yeah, I'm kind of wondering how, too, that's going to affect Easton in a lot of ways.
Yes, yes.
You know, you just heard that Tuttle Crossing is going bankrupt. They're filing a bankruptcy.
Who was that again? I'm sorry.
Tuttle Crossing. Tuttle
I didn't. I'm not surprised, but it's just the first that I've heard.
Yeah, Tuttle. They bankrupt. They haven't been having anything in there forever because of what's, you know, most people have been going to Polaris and Easton. Easton is a different setup also. They still got a lot of outdoor things you can do, even the weather hasn't changed that. We've had some harsh winters, and people still going there to shop, even during the, you know, it's just a different, I don't know how they're going.
Yeah, Easton has a different vibe to it. Yeah, it does.
Huh?
Easton has a different vibe to it.
Yeah, it does. It has a different vibe to it. I think they will survive a lot of this stuff. And I think they will survive a lot of this stuff because most of them stores do have an online thing, but it's not affecting them the same way because of how the clientele, the people that are working in there are a lot younger.
Yeah.
They understand the changes and what's going on as far as this and that. It's a different vibe. It's kind of hard to see what that vibe is, but it's different. It's different than, I think, you know, Polaris may be more in trouble than Eastern. Because Polaris got more still of that traditional type of mall thing.
They are more retail mall.
Yeah, most of your retail stuff that is at Eastern is they don't have a mall as such. Mm-hmm. I mean, you got that little part where you go in, maybe the park, you got food, but most of their stores are outdoors. I mean, you got to go out. You go in and out. So they're not going to have that problem of people piling in places like you would probably at Tuttle or would you have at Polaris. Because there's so many stores that they're only going to accommodate so much space anyway. People going to be so much in and out. And with this virus thing, that's been the biggest area of so many people in the store spreading that way. And that's the saving grace, I think, that's helping Eastern, even though Macy's is, they get hit hard with stuff. I haven't been to Macy's. The last time I went to Macy's, was probably 2017. I was in there with Alice, and that's the last time I remember being in Macy's.
Oh, man, I would have to say, for me, I'm sure it was before 2015, the last time I was in Macy's.
Oh. And I wouldn't have gone in there then, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was the last time I was in Macy's was her.
Mm-hmm.
But she bought some shoes. And another friend of mine that works there, she wasn't even working there at that time, that day.
Mm-hmm.
So, I haven't talked to Pamela. That's what I don't know if she's still working there or what's going on with that.
Okay.
You know, when I heard them, they were closing a lot of stores up, I'm just not surprised.
Right.
You know, even though they built all those parking stuff, you know, they got all that stuff they put out there. I don't know. There's a lot of office space over there, so who knows? You know, what time is it now? Damn, we've been on here about an hour?
Yeah, just about, sir.
Think it's 44 minutes. Let me see.
Yeah, it's about 7:56 now.
Well, my phone says 7:59. Okay, 3 minute difference.
Okay, 7:59. Yeah, I read it wrong. My bad.
Well, yeah, it says 53 minutes on here. On the thing that I got on here. But that's what's happening, people. And you better get used to it, and you better be looking at today. Internet is a necessity, utility you're going to have, and you're going to keep in the game. Especially if you want a job, if you want to be working for somebody else, I'm seeing people hiring off of Zoom calls or whatever.
Well, in the field that my day job is in, it's medical claims. People are doing a lot of seeing their primary care physician via telehealth services. Now.
Right, right.
You know?
Yeah, unless you got something physically they gotta look at. Most of that stuff is doing telehealth type stuff.
Right.
A lot of these physical things like yoga and Pilates stuff is all being done virtual.
Mm-hmm.
You know? It's the only thing that's really kind of kicking in, cutting into my social thing is the salsa dancing thing. Can't really do that virtually. That's just not, you know, I mean, yeah. I seen some places that were open, and I said, I ain't going in there. I see people with masks and stuff on, but I said,
yeah, it's cutting into my social life too. There's a lot of things you can't do, you know.
Yeah.
Social distancing.
I don't know if I would trust going into the gym. Gyms were nasty back before the COVID. You gotta make sure them places are wiped down and people and no.
My daughter has been talking about, and so far I've been lucky when I've gone. Now they're making you wear a mask all the time, you know, the whole time through now, instead of just wearing it when you come in. But my daughter, she's thinking about getting a treadmill. I might just let her go ahead and get it. So, you know.
Get a what?
Get a treadmill.
Oh, yeah. I got a bike. You know. It's just, you know, you gotta be very particular and cautious with what's going on out here. I mean, until we get this vaccine where it's cutting down the spread enough where it's more safe, where it's, you know, we're not in a pandemic situation. Mm-hmm. And that's what the whole thing is about. And, you know, like I said, when I watched that show with Richard Engel, I said, you know, I remember Trump talking about they were working on a vaccine in January. He mentioned it. He didn't say how, but, you know, he has told so many lies.
Yeah, you,
nobody knew what, nobody ever really believed anything he was saying.
Through anything and everything out there, you know.
Yeah, he was like that boy that cried wolf all the time.
Right.
And, you know, and it's interesting now when you look back at all that stuff, he never mentioned nothing about it. Pence, none of the GOP mentioned now anything about, you know, why they were doing it, how they were doing it, which this makes more sense. I always still questioned about, you know, they were only talking about the genoprotein spikes because, you know, the coronavirus is a family of viruses, like the SARS. I mean, I said, well, what is the difference in a spike proteins with like the H1N1, the SARS, all that other stuff versus this one? Nobody's really said. You know, there's been speculation that they thought this thing was kind of manipulated. And, you know, that still hasn't, you know, there's a, you know, that people say, well, that's a conspiracy theory. Well, it was conspiracy theory about how they were getting this vaccine together so fast, but they used technology. So if they could use technology to get the genetic code, why couldn't they have used technology to determine whether this thing was manipulated or man-made.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're nothing but a family of viruses. They were on the Lysol thing before we knew what coronaviruses were. So they knew that there were viruses around. They knew about this coronavirus because corona in Latin and Spanish means a crown, the king, and all that. You know, the corona beer and all that, corona. You know, that's what that means.
Sure.
So it's not like these things were something that came out of the blue. You know, they want to say this is a novel virus, but in truth, in the real truth, nah, it's not a novel virus. They already knew about coronaviruses. It's like the woman that was fucking with the bat coronaviruses. That's where they're kind of suspecting that this may have started from.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't know if this thing spread from them to humans or been able to, because most of the stuff what they were talking about wasn't really a spread from animal to human like that. I just believe stuff's gonna come out in the wash at the end.
Oh yeah, I think we're just once these vaccines have been approved and start to be distributed, I think we're just hitting the tip of the iceberg.
Oh yeah, I do too. I think, you know,
everything coming out.
Yeah, everything usually comes out in the wash.
Mm-hmm.
people gonna get more educated and they're gonna ask other questions. Especially when you, like when I said, when this show was on last, it was on last Sunday and they repeated last night, you know, when you are able to find out a genetic code of anything, a virus, just that gives you an advantage to destroy it or to at least curtail it and control it. Anything mm-hmm. has a genetic code. Everything has a genetic code. We got a genetic code. I said that a long time ago. I said they're all a family of viruses. If they knew what the basic foundation of the virus, they could kill it or curtail it. And that's what they did. And I'm not a scientist. I took biology in school, and they always talk about all living things have a genetic code, some kind of, you know, biological structure.
Right.
However you want to call it. So, well, if you know the biological structure of anything, you'll find out its strength and you'll find out its weakness. And that's what seemed that they're doing. Okay. So that was always my theory about a lot of stuff. And, you know, when I said that earlier, people are like, why don't you know? Okay. Somebody knows something. And I knew. I said, somebody knows something. In this day of technology, I said, somebody knows something. And then, sure enough, that answer came about saying, this is what they did. And I think more shit going to come out too. Okay. To be truthful with you.
Oh yeah.
But we just gotta hang in there and deal with what's going on. I don't know what's wrong with this Emily chick that works for the GSA. She need to get off her ass and just sign off on this stuff that Biden needs.
Oh yeah. Yeah, when and I saw this today, when Christie tells you, give it up, give it up, you know.
Yeah.
Because he's one of Trump's staunchest supporters. And he's like, it's over, you know. I even think, you know, I use my Nino Brown analogy all the time. I even think at this point, Nino Brown would be like, okay, it's over with.
Yeah, you know. And you know, even the guys he brought in from Michigan, they looked at him like, fool, there is no evidence of any fraud nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
Why you got it wasting our time to come over here and talk that shit? Your ass lost.
Mm-hmm.
It's done. Mm-hmm. They just threw out what's his name? Giuliani's case out of Pennsylvania.
Oh my God.
And I would tell them, don't bring me no more shit here. You know, we ain't doing no repeal. Fuck y'all. That's what the judge needs to tell. Don't bring me no shit. You know, you ain't got no proof. There ain't no proof. You ain't got no proof. So you might as well sit your ass down. Go somewhere. Don't come here wasting my damn time. They just threw that shit. Well, Giuliani looks stupid. Got this damn die running off his head. Ain't got no hair on the dome.
That's just, right. Hey, it just use this analogy since it's the Thanksgiving holiday. It's like somebody coming in wanting to learn how to cook it in today's Thanksgiving. Really? Come on, sit down.
Yeah, we ain't here for nobody trying to learn to cook Thanksgiving dinner now. We really want to eat. And we don't want nobody's experiment or shit.
Right, right.
You know. No, we don't do that. I kind of remember a time my mom said a cousin of ours did something with she didn't cook the stuffing for the turkey first. And put the stuffing in the turkey.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, that's what I said. I'm going to leave that there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, man. I don't know. It is what it is. people gotta learn, and we all make mistakes. Ain't no shame to my game. I mean, you just gotta admit that the mistakes you made.
Mm-hmm.
And just like somebody said, and I have to agree. I believe Trump would have won if it wasn't for this COVID situation.
Right. If he
had 73 million people that still voted for him.
Right. If he would have attacked or at least showed half of the effort that he is with this reach out and not conceding, if he would have put even a fourth of that effort towards the coronavirus situation, we wouldn't even,
He got a second term, but he had too much of a hard on. He had too much of a hard on over Obama.
Right.
That's all this was. Exactly. He let all that shit. Masked logic about what he needed to do. So now, he got it up the ass because he had that hard on over Obama and didn't like what he, because he was a two-term black man in the White House.
Mm-hmm.
And it fucked him, really. He would have probably won another term. This is not endorsing or I'm not a fan of Trump's. I'm just calling it as I see it.
Right. Well, the political scientist in me, it says this. That's pretty much all he had to do.
Even if he would have said what we just said about them putting the genetic code up online to help the scientists eradicate this thing, there might have been some chance then. But that makes sense. He didn't say that shit.
Exactly.
All he wanted to do was blame China. Saying it was only affecting brown and black people.
Mm-hmm.
Saying that the scientists didn't know shit. Somebody knew enough to put the genetic code up online to do something, motherfucker. I mean, really. He didn't do none of that stuff, and then he's going to get my walk around here with a... walk around here. Yeah, you fucked yourself. I mean, come on.
Exactly.
You fucked yourself and you didn't get a kiss,
Well, it's always been said that he's always been a man who, if he doesn't win, he's gonna whine until he does. But it ain't gonna happen this time.
Nope. And bad to say, he probably exposed a lot of his stuff by being president, running some of his misgivings, some of his things that he's done. Put his expose a lot of his stuff, even though he didn't show his taxes. That's get ready to hit the fan.
And a lot of he didn't take a dime. He didn't take a dime of his salary. Well, because he would have had to report that as tax. Of course, he wasn't going to didn't want to get paid.
He getting paid other ways.
Right. Exactly.
Now he's hitting up all his base for funds to pay off some of his lawsuit fees and
right
trying to get some bail money.
Oh yeah.
Ain't gonna be no bail money if they figure out that he's money laundering.
I don't know if you sent this, but somebody had sent this to me that the Dutch bank says he owes them like $360 million.
Well, yeah, he owes somebody he's in debt almost $1 billion.
Okay.
He's like, last time I said it was like 421 million, and it's probably more than that. So, and I think majority of that is that from that Deutsche Bank. See, when the clock strikes 12 midnight, day on January 20th, his ass is new mow grass.
Right.
He's exposed all the protective armor that he had as a president. They gonna jump on his ass like white on rice.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why they waiting on.
And he knows it. That's why he.
Yeah. That's why he's showing out. He know that.
Mm-hmm.
He read. I don't know. It's going to be interesting. It's going to be real interesting on what he does or what he doesn't do.
Mm-hmm.
It don't matter. Okay. I think we've been on here, what, an hour and 45 minutes? You got any other things to say? Next to the last Sunset Sunday of the year, next week, last one of 2020, we're going to take a break, about a month, not coming back till January 10th.
January 10th. All right.
January 10th. Put that on your calendar, people. Not, this is not the last one. Next Sunday, the 29th, is the last one of the year. Then we will be gone. We will be gone for a month, not coming back till January 10th. Almost in the middle of January, people. Yeah.
Right. Well, we appreciate you guys coming on, you know, checking us out, hearing us chop it up. As Greg and I will always state, if you want to get started in your home-based business, or if you do have a home-based business and want to establish and leverage your presence, reach out to Greg and myself. We're here. We'll get you steered in the right direction on how to leverage your business, make it work for you, make it more profitable for you. Just reach out to us. We'll meet us halfway. We'll work with you.
Yeah. You know, it's not that I'm not going to be online doing some things, but the show I won't be doing the show on Sundays until January. Because we need a break, man. Sometimes you need a break to redo.
Yeah,
There's going to be plenty of that, because we're going to be 10 days out from the inaugural, folks. 10 days
And we've been at this since March.
Since March of this year.
Pretty much nonstop every Sunday since then.
Yeah, and I've been doing this show since 2016. Okay, so I've just been doing the pattern thing since March.
So Greg needs a break.
you know, I always take a break between Thanksgiving and New Year's and Christmas, all that, you know, from that. Just gotta chill, get renewed, look at what's going on in the news and bring it to people from a different perspective, or try to. You got to take a break. Enjoy your time off.
Yes, sir.
So, you know, like I said, every Sunday I said, you know, you got to relax, enjoy. You don't want to be like so many people, like Les Brown said, you don't want to drop dead at your desk, because you drop dead wherever you're at doing work, they'll replace you. Have your job in the paper before your obituary, folks.
Like that.
You know, they say this, people are stressed between now and that Monday morning, even though a lot of y'all are at home, you're still working for somebody else, and you still got that boss breathing down y'all's neck.
Yeah.
I got time for that. Ain't got time for that. So, hope you got value for what's going on, what we're talking about tonight. Next week, I said, the last one of 2020, going into 2021. We're in the last quarter of we're in the 30 days of the last quarter of 2020. We're going to start. Oh, I know what I wanted to do. Let me see. Let me see what I want. I wanted to show something here. Let me go. I'm see if I can do this.
All right.
You know, we got a thing going into, I don't know if it's going to let me do it. Let me see if this let me go on. I'm trying to go into MLSP. They got a thing that's going on. It's a mastermind class.
Mm-hmm.
Help move the things on for 2021. Uh, Here we go.
It's coming up.
This is what I wanted to show. What is it? That's not the one, is it? Did they take it off already? Prospector recruiting in minutes. That's not the one I'm looking for. Send this page to people who are interested in learning. Okay, no, that's not it.
Yeah, I don't see it.
Yeah, I don't even see it. There was a... let me see. Maybe it's up here. Let's see. New product, new lead gen. There's two new.
It might be because I haven't seen that top new one yet. So that might be it.
Here it is. Social media. Okay, it's this. Does this start this? Let's go here. Is it showing?
It's still booting up.
Well, I mean now, okay. Is it? Do you see it on there now?
Yeah, I see it now.
Okay. Yeah. I'm trying to see if this is that one. Today's when it was. Ain't it either.
Okay.
This is not it. Where happened? That was that other one. There was another one. Okay, well, maybe I'm not supposed to. What was that? Let me see something. There was one that they were product. Is this the one? Okay, maybe. Just saying that Friday challenge, Friday listing. Well, these are some of the products we got that you if you want. Let's see, what is this? Friday challenge posting for profits 30 day. Okay, these are new. What we always talked about, let's go over here. One of the things you need to understand about your business, maybe I'll just do this one. The most important thing that the asset in your business is your list. They've been doing these 5-day challenges for the last year to give you an opportunity to get, you know, 30-day coaching through this system that we've been a part of for a while, like since 2012 I have. This one is simple list leverage 5-day challenge. Okay. You can get this only for $1, okay? How to set up your list quickly. Together, we're going to create, you know, day two. They're going to show you how to do this quickly, set up and start getting leads for your business. They work with you together to create your own, trying to move this out, this thing. How to build your list on day three. Day four, turbocharging. What is this? What is this over here? Let's see. Day three, how to build your list today. Hot market lists for your specific business. This can go with any business, people. It don't got to be network marketing or anything in any business. You got to have a list to get clients and move product and services. day four, they show you how to turbocharge your list, done for you offers and giveaways to quick cash and ultimate leverage. Through this 5-day challenge, they give you a legally swipe mail email copy to write yourself, both work together in sales and signups in your business. They give you a structure of an email swipe, and you can change it so it fit your type of personality in there. And that's how you do it. That's what all this attraction marketing is supposed to be about. Okay. You can get caught up in this for a dollar, folks. Okay. If you're interested in stuff, just let us know. We'll send you the link over. This will help you go into 2021. Because you need a list, folks. You need a list. Without that list, you ain't got no business. That's your biggest asset that you're going to have when it comes to building a business online. With that being said, I hope you got value from what we talked about today on today's show, next to the last one of 2020. My name is Greg Smith, business partner Kent. We'll see you next Sunday. Be there, the last one. I don't know what I'm going to talk about. Maybe I just talk about what we talked about all year. Maybe just go kind of a review. Maybe I just do a review. That's what we do. We'll do a review of what's going on. A review of what we're doing, huh?
I like that.
Just review what we've talked about all year, different things. So it's going to be a year in review of 2020, folks. Yeah. Next week, last show.
We covered a lot of ground.
Yeah. Of what can I say?
Yeah.
All right, people. Take care.